So in this video, I will be cooking two different dishes, and just a warning that one of them will be a chicken dish, and one of them will be a completely vegetable dish. So if you are someone who does not like to see any kind of meat being cooked, if you'd like to just completely forward to the vegetable dish, that starts at about 14 minutes in and 43 seconds. So I hope you can enjoy. So this here is a recipe magazine called Easy Chicken Dinners that includes 125 weeknight recipes with simple sides to match. So today I'd like to look for a recipe from this magazine to cook for dinner tonight. So this magazine here is divided up into these categories: soups and stews, sandwiches and tacos, dinner salads, skillet dinners, pasta and grains, grilled favorites, and baked dishes. So I think I'll look in the category grilled favorites, since it is summertime. So I wanted to choose something that I already had all of the ingredients for. I didn't want to have to make a trip out to the store. And so I found this recipe here. And so this dish here is called Carolina Style Barbecue Chicken. And I did have all of the ingredients. So the ingredients needed to make this dish are a half a cup of yellow mustard, one quarter cup apple cider vinegar, one and a half tablespoons of mustard powder, two teaspoons of hot sauce, one half teaspoon of Worcestershire sauce, salt, pepper, this recipe calls for vegetable oil, but I only had this olive oil available. We'll need 1/4 cup packed light brown sugar. And 2 tablespoons of unsalted butter, melted. Tomato, and this recipe calls for skin on, bone in chicken thighs, but I only had these skinless, boneless chicken thighs. Okay, so first we add the yellow mustard. Vinegar, the brown sugar, and the mustard powder, the hot sauce. The Worcestershire sauce, and some salt and pepper. All together. And now we'll measure out our 2 tablespoons of unsalted butter. So for that we can use this small knife. And we'll measure out our 2 tablespoons. And melt this butter in the microwave. And we'll add it to our mixture. So now we've seasoned the chicken with salt and pepper and put aside a portion of the mustard sauce to use during cooking. And with the remaining sauce, we will coat the chicken and let it sit at room temperature for about 10 minutes. So now this dish is meant to be cooked on the grill, but I will be cooking the chicken on a grill pan. And so we'll spray the grill pan with this olive oil. The chicken. And try to grill the chicken until it has some grill marks. Or until the thickest part of the chicken reaches 170 degrees. And you can baste the chicken with some of the saved mustard sauce. I don't have a baster, so just using this spoon. So now we can slice this tomato. So for that, we'll use this serrated knife. Now this tomato will sit on the plate with the chicken as a side dish. So we'll just make some nice thick slices. Enough for however many servings of chicken you're making. And now we can plate the chicken and add a little of the remaining mustard sauce. Just drizzle a little over top. And so this magazine had recommended to serve the chicken with sliced tomatoes. And for some prepared macaroni salad, which I also happen to have. So there it is, all done. And so I wanted to make one more side dish to go along with this meal. This magazine also has plenty of recipes for side dishes. So I wanted to choose something that would go nicely with barbecued chicken. an avocado radish salad. Now I wanted to choose something cold. Barbecued corn, but I thought that might be too much barbecue. Here I found this recipe for snow pea radish slaw, and I thought that would be perfect to go alongside the barbecue chicken, sort of like a coleslaw, nice cool salad. For this salad, we need one red onion, and we'll need to thinly slice the onion. also need one bunch of radishes. If you wanted to save time, you could buy these already sliced up. We'll want to remove all of these stalks and thinly slice the radishes. Whole bunch of radishes. So now we soak the radishes and red onion in ice water for 5 minutes. And then we'll drain and pat them dry. These are snow peas. We'll need to thinly slice 8 ounces of these snow peas. together 4 teaspoons of rice vinegar, 1/2 teaspoon of Dijon mustard, 1/2 teaspoon of sugar, and 2 tablespoons of vegetable oil, and 1/2 teaspoon of sesame oil, which I didn't have, so I just added a bit more vegetable oil. Now add the sliced snow peas, onion, and radishes in the bowl with the vinegar mixture. And mix it all together, coating all of the vegetables with the vinegar mixture. It's a little easier to use my hands. And finally, season with salt to your taste.